We want to write the line 3x minus 4y equals 15 in slope-intercept form. So we're given a line in standard form, and we want to write it in slope-intercept form with the form y equals mx plus b. So our goal here is to solve this equation for y. So if we have 3x minus 4y equals 15, the first step is to get the x term on the right side of the equation. So we can undo this positive 3x by subtracting 3x on both sides of the equation. So now this would be 0, and then we have negative 4y equals, we'll go ahead and put the x term first, followed by the constant. So we'll have negative 3x plus 15. And then the last step here to solve this equation for y would be to divide everything by negative 4. So we'll divide this by negative 4, divide this by negative 4, and divide this by negative 4. And now when we simplify this, the equation will be in slope-intercept form. Here we'd have 1y, or y. Here, a negative divided by negative is positive, so we'll have 3/4 x. And then here, this would be plus negative 15/4, or just minus 15/4. So once the equation is in this form, we should be able to easily identify the slope and the y-intercept. Remember, m is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept. We do have to be a little careful here because of the subtraction. So first, the slope of this line would be positive 3/4. And then for the y-intercept, since we have minus 15/4, that means our y-intercept would be negative 15/4. And we can write this two ways. We can write the y-intercept is equal to negative 15/4. Or we can write the coordinates of the y-intercept, which would be 0, negative 15/4. And then for the last part, we want to determine two points on the line and then graph the line. And since we are going to have to graph this line, it might be helpful to convert the y-intercept to a decimal. Negative 15 divided by 4 is negative 3.75, so we could write the coordinates of the y-intercept as 0, negative 3.75. So we could use the y-intercept as one of the points on the line. Let's go ahead and do that. We would have 0, negative 3.75. And let's go ahead and plot that point as well. It will be a little difficult to be exact, but it would be somewhere in here, just before negative 4 on the y-axis. And then from here, we could use the slope to determine additional points on this line. Since the slope is positive 3/4, from here we would move up 3 units and right 4 units, somewhere in here. So the graph of the given equation would be this line here. So we just use the slope to help us graph this line, and we can also use a slope to help us determine what the coordinates of this point would be here. Starting with the y-intercept here, since we went up 3 units, we would add 3 to the y-coordinate, and since we went right 4 units, we would add 4 to the x-coordinate. So this point here would have the coordinates 0 plus 4, comma, negative 3.75 plus 3. Again, we added 3 to the y-coordinate because the slope told us the vertical change was positive 3, and we added 4 to the x-coordinate because the slope told us that the horizontal change was positive 4. So another point on the given line would have an x-coordinate of positive 4 and a y-coordinate of negative 0.75, which is the coordinates of this point here. Again, it's hard to tell because this graph is so small and because the y-intercept was not an integer. Okay, so I hope you found this helpful.